Very good morning, guys. So welcome to Exams Pinakya. My name is Raj, your host and host, and I'm back with some words. These are top 10 words for 15th of March 2018. These words would be very important for you if you're preparing for any exam, including this SSC exam which is just going on, and SBI clerk or FCAT exam, and the CDS in September, I guess. So these exams are very important for these kind of exams. Obviously, for those who are preparing for IELTS or any exam, or who wants to study in foreign countries, they have to appear for GRE or IELTS. These words would be very important for those kind of people as well. So I expect you two guys to watch this video full. This is not very long video, this is a short video, so that you can inculcate a lot in a short time. Okay, so I would appreciate if you just subscribe to my channel and like these videos and share to most of the people, so that it can benefit most of them. And obviously there is a statement written here that whenever you are giving any exam, whenever you are preparing for any exam, it is very important the most important trick to solve any question is to understand the question. So when if you are not able to understand the question, you might not able to answer the question. Okay, so this English language is very common now, so it becomes very necessary for you to understand the concept and basic concepts and vocabulary, to increase your vocabulary, to give the answers of the questions for whatever you are preparing for. Okay, so without wasting any time, and please press the bell icon so that you get the notification whenever I upload my new videos in future. Okay, so our first word is hackneyed. So our first word is hackneyed. It means lacking in freshness or originality. So for Hindi ka is sadharan, mamuli, ghisa pita. So things which are very common, which are not unique. Okay, so you can use this word for okay, so this word is very important if you want to use in your daily communication with people. Like for example, every time my internet goes down, the cable company gives me a hackneyed exam explanation. Okay, so there's a person who is complaining that every time my internet goes down, the cable company gives him a common explanation which is not unique. You know, they always give this kind of explanation which has no meaning. Okay, so he is used to listen that kind of explanation from these people. So you can also use this this word in your daily, relate this word in your daily life, and use this word in your daily interactions. The synonyms would be trite, stale, banal, platitudinous, vapid, insipid. Okay, the antonyms would be obviously original, fresh, creative, peculiar, inventive. So things which are original, which are unique, which are creative, those things will be antonym of this word. Okay, so you can use this word very well, I think. Now the next word is trot out. So a very very important. Okay, so to bring to attention of introduce sorry, so dhyan milana. Okay, so there are things you want to bring to attention to somebody, so you can use to trot out for that. For example, the boss trotted out his daughter and introduced her as a new vice president. Okay, so I believe you can interpret the meaning of this example. For the synonyms, show off, demonstrate, flaunt, reveal, disclose, exhibit. Exhibit is a very good word here. Antonyms would be conceal, hide, disguise, veil, camouflage, shroud, obscure. Okay, so very very good word and very easy to understand. Okay, you should use this word in your daily interactions. For the next word is debacle. So it means a great disaster or complete failure. So you can see in this picture, there's a person who got his mark sheet from his school or college or whatever, and he saw that he's failed. There's a F word which is not which means failure, that he's failed, not the F word obviously. So he's failed in history, so he can use this word debacle for that. Okay, so debacle basically means fiasco, failure, catastrophe, disaster, disintegration, mess, wreck, ruin. Okay, the endurance would be triumph, achievement, accomplishment, acquirement. Okay, so obviously when you get failed, you can use debacle for that. But if you have achieved a very good thing in whatever you are targeting, so you can use achievement, accomplishment, triumph for that. Okay, for example, based on low album sales, the singer's new release can be classified as a debacle. Okay, I feel pity for him. For example, the next word is wilt. So to lose strength, vigor, assurance. So there's a as you can see in this picture, there's a toy who works or runs when you charge this toy with this key. Okay, so he moves when he is charged, when the charge is empty, when it is discharged, it will stop. Okay, so you can use wilt for that. So okay, so when you don't have any strength, okay, when you feel tired, you cannot move, you cannot work, so you can use this word wilt for that. For the synonyms would be wither, droop, languish, wane, diminish, dwindle, weaken, ebb. Okay, obviously when you don't have any strength to work, you must be in a weak condition, so you can use wilt for that. The antonyms would be bloom, develop, flourish, surge, alacrity, bolster. Okay, all these words are very important. Okay, example would be, we worried that the long hours of my new job would cause our relationship to wilt. Again, I feel pity for the person whoever is telling this, but a very basic example and very good example to understand. The next word is strident. It means characterized by harsh, insistent or discordant. Okay, tezi se, zor se. So there's, as you can see in this picture, there is a smiley or a person, let us say it's a person who is shouting on this loudspeaker. Okay, so now you can understand the meaning of this word strident. It means characterized by harsh. Okay, a very harsh, rough, grating, rasping, jarring, loud, stentorian. Okay, all these words are very important, and I would not say basic words, but loud is a very basic word, so you can replace using loud instead. Start using strident or strident for this. Okay, so antonyms would be soft, delicate, mellifluous, euphonious, harmonious, muffled. All these words are very important. Example would be, the strident tone in his voice revealed his anger. Okay, so I hope you can understand the meaning. Now the next word is discernible. So it means to see, recognize or to understand something. So let's say you have something and you recognize that thing now, that it is yours, it is not your friend's. Or let's say your friend bought a pair of shoes, a new pair of shoes, and you recognize it, that you have the same kind of shoes. Okay, so you can use discernible for that. So for example, high gas prices are expected to have a discernible effect on the number of road trips taken this summer. Okay, so you can use this word for now, I think. So it means visible, detectable, noticeable, perceptible, observable, perceivable, distinguishable. All these words are very common and easy to understand. Antonyms would be indistinct, invisible, imperceptible, obscure, vague. ambiguous. So obscure, vague, and ambiguous, which means unclear. So things which are clear, which are visible, you can use discernible for that. And things which are unclear, you can use obscure, vague, ambiguous for those kind of things. The next word is tussle. So it's a very basic and very important word. So I remember when I started making these videos, this word, it was a very difficult situation, because I didn't know what to do and how to make these kind of videos for people. So now I have started making these kind of videos, and I am getting a very good response from you guys. So thank you very much for that, and would appreciate if you subscribe to my channel, because I make these videos on a daily basis now. And please share this video so that it can benefit most of the people, which is my target. The meaning of this word is an intense argument, controversy or struggle. Obviously, very basic meaning. Tussle means an intense argument or struggle. Okay, so if you are preparing for any exam, you must be in a struggle period now. You must be feeling that you are struggling, but don't feel but don't have that kind of feeling, because you should enjoy this period also, because it will never come in future again. So for example, they began to tussle with each other for the handgun. So obviously, two persons, one having a handgun, other trying to snatch the handgun. So they began to tussle with each other. Okay, and antonyms would be agreement, compromise, harmonize, truce, accord. The basic words, easy to understand, easy to use. Next word is wither. So it means to lose vitality, force, freshness. Okay, so you bought a bouquet, okay, a bouquet of flowers, and you put them in a flower vase in your home, and after 2 or 3 days you see that you saw that the freshness is gone. Okay, so you can use wither for that. Very easy. Synonyms would be shriveled, desiccate, languish, disappear, vain, weaken. All these words are very important and very easy. Antonyms would be thrive, flourish, rehabilitation, reclamation, sprout, recuperate. Okay, so things which are fresh, you can use these kind of word like recuperate, sprout, flourish, thrive for those kind of words, things. But things which are not, which have lost their freshness, which has lost their freshness, and things which are not fresh now, so you can use wither for that. Okay, so for example, my grandfather said that he would wither away if my mother wasn't there to take care of him. So a very basic example, but a very important word. Okay, so two more words, buckle up guys. Jettison. Okay, so abandon or discard. As you can see in this picture, there is a there are two people, one in red and one in white. Okay, and the red person is discarding the other people, abandoning the other people. He's saying just get lost. Maybe he is the boss of a company, and the white person is just an employee. So the white person is got his termination. So you can use this word jettison for that. It means discard, cast off, abandon, relinquish, eliminate, junk, abdicate. All these words are very important, especially abandon and abdicate. These words are examiner's favorite now. For example, the company president's decision to jettison most of the workforce was made in order to save the business from the bankruptcy. Okay, so antonyms would be keep, retain, preserve, reminisce, okay, encumber, restrain. These words are very important and very easy to understand, I guess. The next and last word is trample. It means to inflict injury or destruction, especially contemptuously or ruthlessly. Okay, ruthlessly, rondna, okay. So as you can see in this picture, there is a plant might be a person who is trying to inflict injury, who is trying to injure this plant, okay, or destroy this plant. You can, so you can use trample for that. Synonyms would be squash, stomp, oppress, trash, overwhelm, ravage, subdue. So instead of using these kind of normal words like oppress or destroy or thrash, you can use this word trample for that. Antonyms would be assist, liberate, emancipate, foster, magnify. These words are very important. Example would be, after her boyfriend cheated on her, she wanted to trample him, so she took all his gifts and crushed them instead. So this happens generally, so it's not so shocking. So very good word, trample. So start using these kind of word. So these were the words for 15th of March 2018. So if you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and share as much as possible. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.